It's been interesting. You know, a couple years ago, you know, we've been together as a staff at the University of Vermont for 7 years, 5 years in Hockey East. We've taken steps, you know, getting to the TD Garden a couple years ago, playing in the championship game against Boston College was a big step. And, you know, last year, obviously, advancing to the NCAA tournament for the first time in our era. You know, those are key experiences for your student athletes, and to have that core back. You know, the biggest thing is that there's they're comfortable, not with who they're playing or what their opponent is or the challenge in front of them, but just knowing what to expect out of travel and the itinerary and all these things. You know, nothing's new to them right now, and they're able to tell the younger guys what's going on and what they need to do to prepare for a big game like this. So I think I'm more comfortable knowing that they're more comfortable.
Yes.
Coach, I'm Andy Bagger with the State Journal of Madison. To what degree does it help you to have as many common opponents this year as Wisconsin had, Denver, Duluth, Yale, those types of things, to give you an idea of what to expect?
It certainly helps, you know, versus playing a team that you can't compare at all. But, you know, I really, in terms of preparation for this week, we looked at, looked at their games this past weekend. I think this time of year, when you get in the NCAA tournament, obviously all the teams are great teams. I think it's a danger to really focus so much on your opponent and instead of focusing on yourselves. We didn't play very well against Boston College, as Kevin alluded to. We played soft in the first period, played better after that. I'm more concerned about getting the most out of our team right now. And that's not to say that we don't share Wisconsin tendencies with our players, because we certainly do that. And we have a strategy in place. But, you know, to get wrapped up in looking back and comparing, you know, how a team did against another team. I think the only thing we can look at and say is that we had some success against WCHA teams this year, you know, split with Denver and beating Duluth. I think that gives our guys a little bit of confidence that they can play with some of the best teams in the country, which we certainly know Wisconsin is one of those teams.
Up front?
This time of year, I mean, obviously you would like to have won that game last weekend. Is there anything to be said maybe though for having an extra day of rest as opposed to a team like Wisconsin, which just got done playing two games last weekend?
I don't know, because you're also battling the mental side of it too. You know, I'd rather have won one game last weekend than not played in two, and, you know, come out as a team that lost a tough game against BC. Our guys were pretty down, and then, you know, we expended a lot of energy, at least I did, Saturday night. I think I burned more calories than the teams that were playing, trying to figure out whether we were going to be in the NCAA tournament or not. So I don't think you can underestimate that part of it as well, just the mentality of the team. And we spent a lot of the week just trying to get our guys refocused and re-energized. I think, you know, naturally they've been given a second opportunity here, so they don't want to take it for granted. But we had to get our guys feeling confident again and getting ready for Wisconsin.
Kind of following up on that, with this feeling of a second chance, kind of, do you think that's really hurt these guys up this week in practice and heading in tomorrow?
I've seen it. You know, I've definitely seen that our team is, it's a good combination of being relaxed. I think that's the experience that we talked about, and being focused. And again, not taking for granted that they have another opportunity to put on the Vermont jersey and represent our institution as well as our state. We felt that was the best part of our experience last year, was sharing it with our alums and, you know, our fans, our families, and certainly I'm sure Wisconsin feels the same thing. When you put on that jersey, it's bigger than you in the NCAA tournament. You're representing a lot of different constituencies, and I just know our guys are thrilled with the opportunity here, and they don't want to let it slide.
In the back?
Could you tell us a little bit more about Braden Irwin and kind of what makes him tick? I mean, when you know that he's going to play well, is there something that you see in his game that you say, okay, here he is?
Well, he plays like a power forward. I mean, he's got an incredible release in terms of his shot at 6'5". You know, he's not the fastest guy on the ice, but he gets to the spots he needs to get to offensively and defensively. But, you know, I think you see him working the puck down low, puck protection, you know, beating guys to the net, playing aggressive without, you know, taking unnecessary penalties. You know, his numbers don't show that he was one of the top players in Hockey East this year, but I think he was. You know, he was a great player for us from start to finish. Braden suffered from some inconsistency issues throughout his career, and I'm just so happy that you know, in his final year as a senior, he's really solved it. You know, and he's been one of our top players from the start to the end, and we're certainly going to rely on him this weekend.
Front.
You guys have been in, I think, 7 overtime games since the end of January. When you get to this time of year, you know, where games are, you know, tend to be a little bit tighter, do you think that experience will help you out?
I think so. We've had success in one-goal games. I mean, I certainly am a big fan of winning games by more than one goal. tends to keep your heart rate down a little bit. But I don't want to say our guys are comfortable with it. I just think they don't lose confidence in those close games or those overtime situations because they've been in it. They know what it takes to win those situations. I think winning that game, you know, in double overtime against New Hampshire in their building was certainly a tough accomplishment that we're very proud of. Not an easy place to win, let alone shut them out back-to-back. They're a great team, obviously an NCAA team. So I think, you know, just having some confidence that we can play in those tight games, which tends to happen this time of year, I think is important for us.
One more, yep.
If you could just pinpoint maybe one thing or a couple things that are big keys to having success tomorrow night.
Well, Wisconsin's a great team. You know, there's not a weakness. You know, they're strong in the net. They have one of the best defensive cores in the country, if not the best. Their forwards are a great combination of grit and skill. So they're going to come at us pretty hard. There's no question about it. I think we have to make sure that we don't fall victim to what we did last weekend and not stand around and watch and be in awe of Wisconsin like we were with BC for a while. We can skate with anybody. We can play with anybody. We've proven that. We just have to have confidence to play our game. You know, you hear these guys talking about playing our game, playing our systems, playing physical. You know, we need to be the team making aggressive mistakes versus the team being passive. I think that's very important that we get off to a good start.
Do you think it needs to be a low-scoring game? Would that work into your advantage?
Not necessarily. You know, we certainly haven't scored as many goals as Wisconsin, but I think if we're on our game, we're it's a good blend of creating scoring opportunities, puck possession in the offensive zone, and making sure we limit grade A opportunities going the other way. So, you know, in an ideal world, it would be, you know, somewhat of a low-scoring game, but I think we can play both styles.
Thank you.